know you can think of many things of how God has kept you. I know you can, all right? And how you have, you've been, some of us even lost loved ones and we thought that we couldn't go on. But we look up to this day and God kept his promise about bringing us joy in the morning and promising us that that he would be with us always. A lot of things happen. Some of you might have even almost got put out of your homes, but God has stayed with you. You know, some of you, your covers might have been a little bare, but you're here today and you're doing all right. What I'm saying is that if we look back as a church family, I know I can remember, and I knew you can. Years ago, Brother Harold Nance, the doctor, didn't have a good thing to say, but God, everybody remember. Amen.
For those of y'all that know that if you're hanging there, the Lord will fix it. And he'll make a way out of nowhere. He said, this is what I want you to do. Ease your arm around with somebody. Now some of y'all didn't do it right, because easing is different from throwing. Easing is when you slip your arm around somebody and that's how that E flat time. And when you need your arm around somebody, my dad would say like this. He said, if you feel like I feel, when I say what I say, I want you to pull them in a little closer to let them know that you agree with what I'm saying. My daddy would say, I tried the man.
Soon as the stuff run out, we stop following God. We pray for a husband.
walk in the person of God walking, and now we got a problem. But we done stood up, don't get mad at me, y'all, don't get mad at me. But we done stood up in the presence of God and say, I'm gonna stay there. I'm happy that God ain't like us. Come on, take your mad face off of a woman and say, okay. Because this is not meant, this section of the message is not meant to make you feel uncomfortable. This section of the ministry is created to let you know that sometimes you got to learn how to pursue God and stop pursuing your own dreams. He says to him, Abraham, obtain the promise. And I want to come by and tell about four of you, it's time for you to get your promise. Listen, to consider it is to reflect and to carefully deliberate. What being said to us here by Jesus? Jesus said, I am the door. In other words, he said, I am the path of entry. I am the means to a new end. This door shows you how to get to a changed life. Three things happen when you go through that door. Salvation becomes available. Movement and travel is yours.